Good morning, everyone. Hello, and welcome to What's New Wednesday at Kimberbell. It is Wednesday, April 17th, 2024. If you are listening to this on the podcast, you are listening to Machine Embroidery with Kimberbell. But if you are watching this on YouTube, Facebook, or Instagram, you are watching What's New Wednesday. Who do I have here with me today? It looks like good morning, Ruth from Iowa and Jennifer from Stormy, Michigan. Ooh, that doesn't sound good. Hello, Kimberly from Tucson, Arizona, and Deanna from Rainy, Tennessee. Hi, Gail, my friend from Cottonwood Heights, Utah, and Sue from Henrietta. I'll say that right. Tennessee. Good morning. Oh my goodness. Hi, Cindy from Tennessee as well. And it looks like Shelley from Kennewick, Washington. Hello, hello, hello. Good morning, Judy from North Georgia and my friend Heidi from Snohomish, Washington. And the list goes on. How are you doing today? I hope really, really great. Got some fun things to talk about today, including the announcement of four winners from last week's two-parter giveaway. Remember, two of you are going to win clear blue tiles from last week's Western Wednesday, and two more of you are going to win fat quarter bundles from our shopping spree at Inside the Hoop. Plus, all four of you are going to win a Kimberbell tote. Just lots of fun stuff to be talked about today, the winners and all kinds of other things, including a brand new sneak peek at something that we have not yet talked about. So that's always fun, right? So let's go ahead and kick this off with a little bit of Sew and Tell with Kimberbell. All righty, it looks like you guys are having fun at Day at the Spa again, and I loved this image because it shows how perfectly giftable these projects are at the brand new event called Day at the Spa. It's never too late to join a shop who's doing Day at the Spa because they can do it virtually or in person, so no matter how you take it, people are loving it, like this one. This comes from Mary. She said, made some gifts recently. Boy, Mary, if I count that up, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bags. It's a very giftable event. So not only did Mary make those and they look fantastic and you have 9 lucky recipients of those, boy, are they fortunate, right? But you are also making other things that are very giftable like this one. This is from Laura. She says, ready to gift to my granddaughter for her birthday / graduation. The zipper bag holds some cute nail files, another bath bomb, and another bar of lavender soap. Now to make the rope bowl. She says, now to make me a rope bowl. Yes, Laura, not only do you want to gift it, but keep one for yourself too, right? That rope bowl is gorgeous. Everything turned out so great. Your granddaughter is a very, very lucky gal to have you as a grandma. All right. Thank you for sharing those. Again, it's not too late to find a shop that's doing Day at the Spa. They're doing them right now as we speak and into the coming months. It's going to be awesome. It's a great one, especially to do before Mother's Day because those projects truly are so giftable. Now, we've been talking about One Hoop Wonders. This is so exciting for me to see when you guys are already making them. Let's see what Sherry did. She says, finish the citrus topper I started last week. If you haven't tried these new One Hoop Wonder designs, you are missing out. They are the best of both worlds, machine embroidery and machine piecing. Quick, easy, lovely quilts that are so giftable with so many options. They make using your scraps and stash so easy. The planning worksheet, yes, I'm glad you mentioned the planning worksheet, is amazing. And then there are the new large-scale quilting designs. Love, love, love. Okay, she's loving this. I love it. I love what you did, Sherry. Look at this citrus design that she put together. Isn't that gorgeous fabrics? Oh my gosh, I love it. And you used one of the 5 layout options there for piecing that together. And she did her quilting with the brand new large-scale quilting designs. This is the citrus. So can you see the lemons in there and the leaves and the oranges and all the things? Perfect for that design. But Sherry, I bet you're going to use that design elsewhere as well. That's what's so cool about it, right? Now, these next pictures I loved because like Sherry did with the citrus, these ladies also did citrus. And it goes to show that there's a lot of different ways to put these together, okay? There's lots of options, but because of fabric choices, they all look very different as well, and each of them are so beautiful. Look at this one. This is a table runner that Kathy had fun with. She says she had fun playing, mixed a few designs from Red, White, and Bloom. That lemonade that you see there is from Red, White, and Bloom, the one in the picture. The June mini quilt, yep, that lemonade right there in the glass is from the June mini quilt. And the newest One Hoop Wonder, next One Hoop Wonder for her is the pumpkins and the arrows. Kathy, let's take a closer look at yours so everyone can see how darling that is. Again, switch up of the different fabrics, but a different configuration. And then she added a couple of other designs from Kimberbell products, which just makes me so happy to see. That is the whole point of One Hoop Wonders. It's a mix and match and really kind of choose your own adventure kind of thing. And I'm loving seeing everyone's renditions. Please keep posting them. I want to see them. And I know everyone else does too. Now, again, One Hoop Wonders, citrus design, different fabrics, different layout. Let's see what Karen did. She said it was fast to put together. And boy, is that just like this gorgeous pop of color there behind her citrus. Oh, I love that purple in the background there. Just gives it a whole new look and feel, doesn't it? It's absolutely gorgeous. She did her own rendition of the block setting with, you know, again, the different fabrics. And then she used the all over leaf quilting all over it. And what's cool about that, guys, is the leaf quilting actually was part of the bundle for Quilting Through the Seasons. And you could buy it as a separate download too. But see why we sell these things separately is because it's not about just using the one quilting design on the one project. It's about seeing what else is possible. And like she did there, she used that quilting design on One Hoop Wonders and it looks amazing. Yet she can still use it on Quilting Through the Seasons and everything else that she can think of. I love it. I love it. So thank you, thank you, thank you for sharing. Speaking of background quilting, here's a couple more that shows that it doesn't always have to be a Kimberbell project that you're quilting on. You're using your embroidery machine to use Kimberbell's background quilting on all kinds of projects, including panels, which I love. Heather says she decided to give clear blue tiles a try, especially now that the larger templates fit her largest hoop. Yes. This wall hanging will be done in 16 hoopings. She says she's pleased with the results. So you see what's going on there? She's got the nice little swirls going on. Larger scale design, larger hoops for her specific hoop size. And she's going to be able to get that done lickety split. Pretty cool. And then this one, this panel was cute. This was a baby, one for a baby, and she was able to use clear blue tiles to finish it. She said, Wendy says, procrastination at its best. My goddaughter is having her second baby tomorrow, and I just finished binding this. I used clear blue tiles, and it was so easy. I've never used them on a quilt size. The bonus to this story is that she will also be her baby's nurse. That is pretty cool. What a bonus that is, Wendy. But look at that. Again, a quilted panel or a panel now just goes right to that finish line very easily with the machine that you already own, an embroidery machine. Very, very cool. Okay, here's a few more to round us out today. This is from Mini Quilts Volume 1. January through June, and people are having fun with May and June. Let's take a look. June, this one definitely is one of my favorites. Lenny says, finally finished all 6 months. And boy, did it turn out cute, didn't it? I love that lemonade. And I love the little jar of strawberries. You know that lid on there is a dimensional fabric for that. And then you put some twine on it. Oh, so cute, isn't it? I want to take just that block and put it on something else. So cute. Okay, this one comes from Debbie. She says, finished May and June's minis. My first time using wash away thread on the flowers. So much easier than trying to find the bobbin thread and snipping it. Yep, I totally agree. She used some fabric scraps for her backing and borders from her stash. She says, June is her favorite mini so far. Yeah, I'm right there with you, Debbie. June is my favorite too, but let's look at May because it is so darling as well. See, she used the water-soluble thread on those fringe flowers. And then here I didn't grab the June one from you. But yeah, you can see the June is the fruit one with the lemonade and blueberries and such. Really fun. And then this one also is June, but this one comes from Marlene. She says, here is a June mini quilt. I'm loving making these. I'm looking forward to July through December ones. Kimberbell, any hints for us on those? Marlene, your wish is my command. You ask, I'll answer. Yes, I'm going to show you today just some sneak peeks of not the full ones. I don't do that quite yet. But just some little snippets from July through December. You're going to lose your mind, guys. They are cute. If you thought volume one was cute, January through June, oh, you just wait. Till July through December, we'll be talking about that. So Marlene, good question. All right, let's carry on to what's new as far as a background quilting design goes. We've got two of them this week. Both of these, I will mention that if you are part of Perfectly Pieced with Me Time, they already came in your box. It was in March, the March grouping of Perfectly Pieced. So it's like a bonus. You already have those, right? That's pretty cool. But if you're not part of Perfectly Pieced, these are available to you today. So this is awesome. And they're both kind of like this just very general geometric in nature type of designs. This is an all over blue design. Guys, remember that light blue color means it can be, it works perfectly with both clear blue tiles and block by block quilting. So that's exciting. Let's look at it again. Okay. I love these more like general designs because they can be used for any season of the year. It's not, you know, themed so much that you can't use it for all kinds of projects. So that's a good one right there. And then you're always looking for more border designs. This is a block by block border design. And that means it's repeatable. Just like that. And everything's going to line up as if you had it at a long armor. So again, very geometric in nature and perfect for, you know, just kind of more general designs or maybe even more of a modern look as well to your quilts. So you get the two different designs. You get the one to the left is for 1 and 2 inch borders. The one to the right is for 3, 4, 5, and 6 inch width borders. Both of them are now available at kimberbell.com. So we'll put the link in the notes. All right, let's talk about, let's see, in case you missed last week's What's New Wednesday, I just wanted to share with you a little bit about what we talked about. And that is the new Clear Blue Tiles Set 2, Expansion Set 2. And that was for the larger tiles. Right. If you have larger hoops, larger than a 9x14 hoop, you're going to be interested in getting Clear Blue Tiles Expansion Set 2 because now you have like 16 inch lengths of tiles instead of just like a 14 inch length. So you can go wider, you can go longer, and that is the brand new expansion set. So those of you who have those hoops, look for expansion set two. You're going to get your projects done faster because it's less hoopings, right? So I just wanted to give you a little reminder of what Clear Blue Tiles expansion set two is all about with this little video. Let's take a look. Okay, so there you go. Very, very exciting. People are thrilled that they can use their larger hoops with this. They're perfect for the new large scale background quilting designs. All right. Let's see. So with that being said, because we talked about Clear Blue Tiles last week, and that's part of the giveaway, are you ready for the announcement of the two winners of any Clear Blue Tile set that they asked for? One option, of course, was the essential set. The second option was you could ask for the expansion set one. And the third option was you could ask for the expansion set two. So without further ado, I've got some winners here. It looks like for the essentials set, that's the main set that everyone would want to start with, Vicki Smith. Congratulations, Vicki Smith. That is coming your way. So make sure and reach out to us with a direct message on Facebook would work, or just emailing us at Kimberbell, and we will make sure that gets to your door. The second winner of the Clear Blue Tiles giveaway. Oh, when I say Clear Blue Tiles, you not only get that, but you also get the tote, the Kimberbell tote. The second person is Rosita Blackwelder. Rosita Blackwelder, congratulations. You asked for expansion set two. You're getting expansion set two and a Kimberbell tote. So congratulations to those two winners. Let's see. So the other two winners are going to come right now, in just a few minutes, as I talk about what happened on last week's Inside the Hoop show. Now, last week's Inside the Hoop was when Ginger and myself and Deanna did a little bit of damage to our wallets. No, just kidding. Never. In shopping for fabric, are you kidding? It's all good. We had some fun shopping for fabric at our local quilt shop. And so we were doing that as we were excited to talk about and share with you One Hoop Wonders. Now, with One Hoop Wonders, of course, that's, you know, based on the pictures that you saw today, there's a lot of things you can do. There's the different design elements, there's the different layouts. And so we did a little bit of fabric shopping. So if you missed that episode of Inside the Hoop, it's not too late to watch it. I think you'll find it fun to watch. And you'll learn something new about choosing fabrics. Okay. So sometimes fabric, you know, choosing the fabrics, if it's not already bundled up for us, we get kind of nervous, right? Oh, is this gonna work together? So we give you some tips for choosing those fabrics all over a quilt store, not just within one line of fabric. We actually called it line jumping. Kathy says, you guys showed great restraint. Yes, we did. Linda feels like it was fun shopping with you girls. Oh, good. Hopefully you learned something new about choosing fabrics with all that, right? So we did do that. Please watch it when you get a chance. But that was the One Hoop Wonders. A few weeks ago, I actually talked about, let's see, here we go. We talked about, Hold on just a minute. Okay. I talked about One Hoop Wonders. Let's do a little recap on what I said about One Hoop Wonders. And then I'm going to show you a video a little bit more in detail about that. So here's the recap from a couple of weeks, all about One Hoop Wonders. In the video, you're going to love what one of my colleagues, Joy, was making. She did the rainbow over the rainbow, and she did it in kind of a more boho color scheme. Take a look. Idea behind One Hoop Wonders is this. One Hoop Wonders is very simple applique, so you truly can just sit down at the machine and you just do this repeatable block over and over again to make a gorgeous quilt in the end. Okay, so that's kind of fun, right? That rainbow is just one of the five appliques choices that you've got in there, but you know, mix and match all kinds of Kimberbell appliques, right? Let's see, what was I gonna say about that? That, like I mentioned, is a repeatable block, so it makes it really quick, easy, fun, all of it. And then you quilt it. Okay. So here's another look at a little bit more in-depth video about what One Hoop Wonders is. Okay, so who's excited? Who has been working on One Hoop Wonders already? Anyone? Share what you've been making with One Hoop Wonders. Yeah, you know, Pam, great question. She says, has anyone made a full quilt using the entire variety of the block, like a sampler quilt? I bet. If someone hasn't yet, someone will. There's no doubt. So keep joining, watching on Kimberbellas and Fellas page, because if you are doing any kind of One Hoop Wonder, whether you mix and match or show the whole, you know, line or design of appliques that are available, or you know, you choose other Kimberbell designs, we want to see them for sure. Let's see. Lisa says she just got hers. She can't wait to start. Yeah. Really, really fun. Cindy, you're totally right on that. She says ginger line hops to the Kimberbell accessories. Yeah. If you haven't watched last week's Inside the Hoop episode, please go back and do, because not only did Ginger have fun fabric shopping, she kind of jumped on over to the Kimberbell accessory wall and filled her cart over there as well. That was too cute. Ooh, let's see. Sherry, you're on fire, my friend. She says, I'm loving it. I have some pumpkins and arrows made. Sherry, can't wait to see it. That's good. Good. Loved the line hopping. And says, yeah, we were jumping lines from fabric to fabric line. Anyway, that was a fun video, right? In that book of One Hoop Wonders, you get, of course, the five applique designs, five different layout options, and an exclusive background quilting swirl design. That's one of the large scale quilting designs. That's an exclusive that comes with that product. And that will use, you know, you can use that swirl design even if you have a smaller hoop. So that's good news. You don't have to have the largest hoop. You can use the large scale quilting designs on anything from a 4x4 tile size and larger. So you'll be good there. Now, that being a fun video, I had to share this quick little reel that I thought you would like as well. And it's a little bit more about the behind the scenes of making the video I just showed you. Just for fun. Let's take a look. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there you saw, these are for cuddling. These are for certainly wall hanging quilts. Something to throw over a ladder rung would be cute. Something to throw over your couch, and they're quick and repeatable. And I think you're going to love it. It's a little different for us at Kimberbell because you know we love the embellishments. And we're not going away from that by any means. There's lots of fun stuff in the works for more embellished types of quilts for wall hangings. But sometimes you just want that cuddle quilt, a little bit easier, a little bit quicker, a little bit softer. And that is why we did One Hoop Wonders. All right. So with all that being said, I have the announcement of two more winners. This came from the Inside the Hoop show last week. When we went fabric shopping, we said, hey, is, you know, which of those fabric bundles would you like to have? It was, you know, Kim's Christmas Tree Farm, Ginger's Over the Rainbow, or Deanna's Slice of Summer. I would say that, you know, you can't go wrong with any of them, and that's how you guys felt too. But with random drawing, the following two people have won their choice of fabric bundles. Margaret Morgan. Margaret Morgan, congratulations. Please reach out to us and we'll get that out to you. And Connie Montgomery. Margaret Morgan, Connie Montgomery, you get a dozen fat quarters to get you going with a One Hoop Wonder quilt. Or any project you want, really, right? With fat quarters. And then and also a Kimberbell tote. We'll get that out to you. All right. So moving right along, I have a sneak peek for you. It's not much, I know, because it's coming out in a few weeks, so we're just teasing it up to that point. But I think it'll be enough to get you excited about the brand new Mini Quilts Volume 2. Mini Quilts Volume 2 is about to be released in just a couple of weeks, and boy, is it cute. When you think of Volume 2, think July through December. When you think July through December, think holidays. When you think holidays, think Kimberbell cute, right? So much fun with these little mini quilts. July through December is coming out just around the corner, so why not show you a little peek at them? You want the full collection, right? Oh, you get a really big peek that with that one with December on top. But that's showing you that there is an array of designs, one for every month. And boy, are they stinking cute. Let's first start off with July. Little sneak peek at that. How do you like those popsicles? And underneath the popsicles, it's covered in vinyl, and underneath it is like this glittery confetti stuff to give it some sparkle and shine. You know, we don't ever mind enough sparkle and shine. And that is part of July's. I will give you another image or two of July. Here we go. Yes. Don't you love the USA nod to the USA with that heart? Do you see some little watermelon in there too? Now, if you are a friend in Canada, I've got good news for you. Look at that. You have an option. So whether you go with the USA option or the Canada option, it's there for you. And if you are from another country, you know, I wish we could make these designs for every country out there. But how cute would it be still to take just that heart and put, you know, just an applique fabric that represents your country so well? That would be darling in there. So that is July's little mini quilt. Are you ready for August? All right, here we go. August, look at that. Do you see what kind of hints do you see in that one? What do you see over, let's see, right there? Do you see something that might go, oh, wait a minute. I spy maybe a flamingo. Mm-hmm. Maybe a glitter flamingo. Mm-hmm. But what about that cute little tote bag? That's a pocket that you roll up some fabric and stick it in there to look like a beach towel. So cute. Beach umbrella. There's a new material we put in the embellishment kit for that umbrella. I think you're going to love it. And some bathing suits. Okay. What about this one? This is also in August. Dip into summer. That gives you a hint, right? Dip into summer. Something I love about that one is look at the stitching on that summer. It is stitching. It looks like applique, but it's this really cool motif, which I think is super fun. And then, of course, really easy, right? Okay. You guys are excited. Valerie says the mini quilts are so cute. I know. So fun. Okay. Hi, Peggy. Oh my gosh. Very, very fun. Beach theme for August for sure. All right. Are you ready to get into a little bit more? Well, not quite holidays yet, but let's take a look. Yeah, I know, Janet. Where did you go, Janet? Let's see. She says Kim and her teasers. I know. I can't help it. Okay. Let's look at August. No, we already looked at August. Let's look at September. Here we go. Oh, where did it go? There we go. Okay. Thankful. Love it. Love it right there. You see some acorns maybe in the background, some mushrooms, very more September-like, right? We're, you know, heading into fall there. I love even that leaf there with the where it says thankful, because I'm picturing putting just even that block onto tea towels. I think that would make the cutest gift, as well as decorating my home. So I already know. I'm like, I looked at that. Yep, that's what I'm doing with that specific block. But here's another look at another portion of the quilt with this sweet little house. Love it. Doesn't it scream September? Yeah. And the start of fall. Ooh, a chill in the air, right? Okay. Are you ready for a teaser on October? I almost hesitate to show you October. I'm going to show it to you. You know I will. But I'm telling you right now, the pictures don't do it justice. When I see it in person, I'm just like, I got to have it. I got to have it. And the extra little doodads on it that you make on your embroidery machine are just darling, like this cupcake. Look at that. Do you see that right there? The little topper on the cupcake is this dimensional piece of candy there that you make on the machine. So darling, this is sweet and spooky treats. Oh yes, and look at that cupcake with a candy corn. Okay. How about two more cupcakes for you for Halloween? Look at that. Look at the ghost. Are you kidding me? The ghost. The ghost. Need I say more? The ghost. The whipped cream ghost. So cute. All right. That's October. What do you guys think? Melissa. She says her birthday's in October. Missy says she loves the witch's hat. Oh, yeah. Love the ghost, Heidi says. And Amy says, love them all. Love the cupcake ghost. Yeah, I do too. Wait till you see it in person. It is really, really cute. All right. Okay. Are you ready for November? This one's kind of fun because it's a little bit more formal in nature, right? It's still cute, but not cutesy. You know, you hear me? Cute, but not cutesy. Look at this. November. That's a plaid felt, my friends, for that pumpkin design. Mm-hmm. Yep. And I adore this turkey design. Autumn harvest farm to table. Okay. So cute. Again, a little bit more formal in nature. Cute, not cutesy. I love it. And I think any of those designs in November would look so darling on an apron. I'm only showing you half the quilt, guys. Wait till you see the other half. Really cute. And then finally, the December. Okay. I'll give you more of a look at the full one on this one, since you saw it maybe a little bit earlier too. Here we go. This uses some new Kimberbell fabrics as well, which is kind of exciting, right? And look at these stamps. Ah, that bell. Are you kidding me? The bell. So, so darling. Let's look at the snowflakes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. The pictures really don't do it justice. I'm telling you, when you see them in person and you make them, you're just going to squeal. It is so, so fun. So that, my friends, is your sneak peek. Sorry, not giving you any more for another week or two. Right? So cute. You know, the thing I love about mini quilts is that it is something I can sit down at my machine and truly get done in an evening or an afternoon or, you know, in a day, because they're mini, they're 12 by 12. And then I can just swap them out either on a tabletop stand or hanging on my wall. I've seen people turn those mini quilts also into pillows. So that's certainly an idea too. There's lots of things you can do with that. You're getting a project done from start to finish in a relatively short amount of time. And the results are darling, darling. Okay. So very, very excited about that. Ooh, yeah. Debbie, she says the dimensional cupcake topper would make cute earrings. You are right. I love that idea. I'm good. I may have to do just that. That's awesome. Oh, Lisa, see you guys ask and I will answer eventually, right? She says, when will the sneak peek for Gingerbread Christmas come out? Very, very soon. How's that for an answer? Terrible. I know, Lisa, I'm sorry. It will happen very soon. There is a new event that will be coming out called Gingerbread Christmas, and we certainly are going to do that too. So very excited about mini quilts, mini quilts. You'll be able to find those online and in shops wherever Kimberbell products are sold, July through December. It's coming out before you know it in just a couple of weeks. All right. Just before we go into our giveaway today, a few last minute reminders for today. It looks like I want to remind you that Kimberbell Day is coming up, well, in a few months. Just mark your calendars, right? For Saturday, July 27th, 2024, we are doing it as a half day. So it's going to be from 9 to 1 p.m. Mountain Time. So think about where that is in your neck of the woods. Kimberbell Day. You can take it at your local quilt shop. You can watch it online, wherever you're at. But it is going to be filled with so many fun things, tutorials and sneak peeks and a ton of giveaways. You know, we'll do the giveaways again, and they're big. You're going to want to be part of that. So July 27th on a Saturday morning. All right. Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon. Quilt shops do all kinds of fun celebrations with that too. It's a celebration of all things machine embroidery, all things Kimberbell. We hope you'll join us. So there's a reminder for you. Another reminder is that we have the brand new large scale quilting design still on sale. I think it's until May 1st. So I just don't want you to forget. Yeah, May 1st, you can save 25% on this bundle of large scale quilting designs. You can buy them as a bundle and save 25%, or you can also buy them as individual downloads. These are ones we did certainly use in One Hoop Wonders, but absolutely you can use them for anything, as demonstrated in our sew and tell today. So that was cool to see them being used beyond just the One Hoop Wonders. Let's see. And then another reminder is to join Deanna, Ginger, and I tomorrow, Thursday, April 18th, for another episode of Inside the Hoop. It is going live at 10 a.m. Mountain Time. And in tomorrow's episode, we're going to show you how to quilt those One Hoop Wonders that we did last week. All right. So join us for that. Should be a lot of fun. And you're going to learn, again, some more tips for doing background quilting and such. We hope you'll join us for that episode. If you catch it at 10 a.m. Mountain Time. Certainly it's recorded. You can watch it at your convenience. All right. Now for today's giveaway, it's a little different again than we've done before. Instead of making a comment here, I'm actually going to have our team post a link. We're doing a little bit of market research. We could use your help with this market research. It's a very quick survey, okay? It won't take more than a minute or two to fill out, but three people who fill out this survey are each going to win a Kimberbell Quilting Through the Seasons tote with the Quilting Through the Seasons book and CD and embellishment kit. Three people are going to win that just by helping us out a little bit and quickly filling out a little market research survey. All right. And I promise you the questions are easy. there's like multiple choice, you know, and we want to know like, what is it that you're looking for with, different Kimberbell products coming out. We want to hear from you. We do listen and we do take it all into account. So if you wouldn't mind filling out that survey, the link is in the show notes. We're also going to put the link in the comments several times, but it's really quick and easy. It's something that we started posting it yesterday. So maybe you already filled that out. But three people are going to win that tote bag, book and CD, and the embellishment kit, which is pretty cool. And hey, I mean, if you've already purchased those things, because I know a lot of you have, then who wouldn't love to have a friend gift that to them, right? I'm sure someone in your life would absolutely adore you. Well, they already do adore you, right? But they would love and be so grateful if you gave them your winnings. Should you have already bought that, right? Or if you just want to help us out, we would still love to have you finish out or complete that 2 minute or less, probably even less, survey. So like I said, link is in the comments. We would absolutely love for you to help us out. And therefore we can also help you out by maybe having you win a really, really great price. Oh, good. Awesome. Barbara says she filled it out. That's wonderful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We would be so grateful. Kathy says that would be a lovely gift for her sister. Sounds like she already did it, has that. So that would be awesome. No one would complain about getting that, right? So it's just a quick 2 minute survey. Like I said, we've got the link in the show notes above or in the comments here. We'd be so grateful. All right, everyone. Thanks for being here today. As always, we certainly appreciate it. Love visiting with you, chatting with you, seeing what you're making. Keep doing it. We love it all. Keep doing what you love, my friends, and keep experiencing the joy of creativity. Bye-bye.